Hey folks, this is Moondan Raghavan. Today we are going to see Python regular expression session 2. In previous session, we have seen what is regular expression and why it is required, and we have seen different kind of meta characters and its interpretation. So in this video, we are going to cover some of the functions from the regular expression, which are like compile function, find iteration, group function, start function, end function. The code snippet for this you can see here. Import re, so we are importing the regular expression module from Python. Pattern, so we are creating some pattern to use in the later stages. So re.compile, so this compile function will compile your regular expression so that you can use this pattern object in the later stages. So under compile you will give r, within single quotes you will give your pattern. Okay, so here r stands for raw text or regex. In some cases, R will be used as a raw, because let's say if you are using slash T or slash S, so it should be considered as a slash S only. Because in normal time, if you don't give R, it will be considered as a space or it will be considered as a tab. So generally, we are escaping the escape characters by using the R. In other way, we can tell we are using a regular expression. It's not like a direct string. So then after we are giving the pattern, pattern is just like 0 to 9. So it means that any numeric value followed by k. And after that we are printing the type of pattern. So you can see what is the type of pattern there. And after that matches. So here find iteration method we are going to use by using the pattern. So by using the pattern, we are find iteration method, we will give the target string. So what it will do is by using the pattern, it will check in the target string. And find iteration method will return the iterator object. So this iterator object will have all your matches. Then after we are trying to see whether it is which type of object for the matches. Then after we are creating for loop. So for match in matches, then you will get each match and you will see match.group, match.start, match.n minus 1, because it always give n. Okay, I will tell from the starting. So match group will give every group from the matches. So let's say in your case, so the matches may be like manually we can see. So any number followed by k, so you can say 2k, and then you can say 4k, and then 7k last one. So you may be getting 3 outputs, right? So each output or each group will be considered as a own group. So that's why for every time you will get one group output. And after that, let's say you have given any kind of regular expression. So it will be starting from one position and ending at one position. So ending position will be always given with n plus 1. So that's why in the output, we are changing n minus 1 and start we are getting as it is. And however, when you make the print statement with other string, it has to be string. So for that reason, I am just converting the output integer or output index as string. Then after last line stands for just print a line with asterisk symbols, it will have 40 asterisks. So without delay, we will just go to the direct execution and we'll see how it goes. So here you will have two patterns here. So for show the two kind of demos, I am creating two patterns here. And first of all, some may ask, why do we need to compile that and we need to have the pattern? Because you may be using a different kind of patterns for different reasons. For example, for finding phone number one pattern, for finding rupees one pattern, or finding register number one pattern. So you need to, if you create the pattern, it will be reusable in later stages. And if you want to edit some pattern, you will be editing at one place rather than editing a multiple cut places. It's a similar concept of variables. So however, you will see the code one by one. So import re as usual, it's a importing statement for regular expression from Python. And pattern one, here we are seeing the same whatever we have seen in the slideshow. So any number followed by k. And second pattern is just like a Indian number. What I'm telling you is here the number, starting number will be 9 or 8 or 7. Then after any digit, because now here I am not using the set, I am using the special symbol. So slash d means any digit. And any digit can be length of 9 only, because already we covered the first digit. It can be either 8. Or 8, sorry, either 8 or 9 or 7. In other 9 numbers will be the digit. Next one, I am displaying the pattern 1. So which kind of pattern? Now we will see the output as well. Next one, I am creating the matches. since it says two matches, so matches one and matches two. So first matches, it will be looking at the target string for finding any number followed by k. And second pattern will be matching the target string, which has the three different kind of phone numbers, okay, which has the different kind of numbers. All will have the 10 numbers. And if you don't have starting at the 8 or 9 or 7, it will be rejected. For our instance, it will be deleting the last one, or it will be disregarding the last number. And I am displaying the matches type also here. So I am going to display the for loop for both. Matches one, for matches one, how many matches come? I am going to display each match, and after that, same like for matches two. So just we will execute and see how the output goes. Perfect. So if you see that in the first one, any number followed by k, so 8 followed by 5, so it's not one, 5k is the one. So we can say 5k, and it starts at third position and ends at fourth position. So index is 0, 1, 2, 3, third position 5 and fourth position k. Next one 8k, so it's here. So its position also 7 and 8. And last one 3k, its position 14 and 15. And however, you will see the pattern. So pattern type is SRE pattern. And second one iterator, because the pattern find iterator method will give the matches. So matches is type of callable iterator, because it iterates every group or every matches from the regular expression. So next one, this number should be coming and this number should be coming. This number should not be coming because we have only 987 as the prefix. So you can see clearly here. So it is coming 8 and 9 series. It does not have the 3 series because it does not start with 9 or 8 or 7. So this is all about regular expression and some of the methods we have seen. The methods are compile, start, end and group. And we have seen what type of find iteration. Actually, we have seen the find iteration method also. And we have seen what is the output of find iteration. So find iteration output will be the callable iterator. And we have seen the pattern. So it is SRM pattern type. So that's all about today's video. So thanks all. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.